Hi guys, I'm back with a new video. I am a little bit out of breath and a little bit exhausted. Quite exhausted, pretty exhausted. Because I spent an hour and a half with my dog in a forest. And there was a lot of rain and a lot of wind. And it was cold and I didn't have my striped shirt. Because, you know, it's drying. So I had to use something else and pull the sleeves out of my jacket and improvise a little bit. Which I did. So I survived 1.5 hours. But let's get to it. This video is about a comment that somebody placed under a video. And it had to do with witches eating babies, I think. I couldn't find the comment when I checked the notifications. So maybe it got deleted or something. I don't know. Maybe I just missed it. Probably, most likely. But I decided to do this video because it's fun. Babies are interesting, really interesting. Now, we all know how babies are made and we all know how babies are born. If you look at movies, it involves a lot of blood and screaming and yelling and pushing. And thing is, if you just let things happen, it will just slide and pop out naturally without too much of a fuss and hustle and stress and but that's about giving birth. What happens is, because the baby comes out of the mom, it has the same smell as the mom, at least for a very long time, even up to a couple of months. And the fact that the baby smells like the mom makes it very easy for the mom to accept the baby, because it smells like her. And also the dad is like, if he holds the baby for the first time and gives it a kiss on the forehead, it smells like the mom. And this adds to the mom and the dad accepting the baby as being theirs. And it will activate love in the both of them. So that's a good thing. Then another thing happens with babies and little kittens and puppies and even a little chicken or a little bird. They are born with a big head, huge eyes, little nose and a small mouth. For some odd reason, especially humans, look at something with a big head and big eyes and tiny nose and small mouth as, it's so cute, I want to kiss it, I want to cuddle it, I want to take care of it and keep it safe and warm. And that's what a big head and big eyes and do with especially women. It doesn't work as well on men as it does on women, but it's there. Now, there's another thing. If a baby is smart and born with a effective survival mechanism, it will be born with the appearance of the dad, or at least it looks like the father. That to prevent that the father will reject the child and maybe kill it or something. Lions, for example, if an old lion is replaced and pushed out of the group and another alpha lion takes over, all the moms know that their little ones are going to die. The first thing another lion does is get rid of the old lion and put himself in the alpha spot and then check all the moms, kill all the babies and prepare them to have new ones that are his, not the one that left, not from the one that left. He just doesn't want anything to do with that DNA. He wants to have his own DNA in the group. So unfortunately, all these little lions are going to die. That's nature. So if a child, like I said, is born with an effective survival mechanism, then he or she will make sure that it looks like the father. And the funny thing is, if you go to a party, baby shower or something, it's always smart to look at the baby and say, it's so cute. There are a lot of ugly babies in the world. Not all of them are Perfectly shaped and beautiful and cute and cuddly. There are babies with big noses, especially boys. Boys are, I don't know, there's always something weird about boys, but don't get me wrong, I love babies. Everybody knows I'm a mom, but the first thing you say when the baby is shown to you is, it's so cute, and even if you don't think it's cute but plain ugly, you think, oh, that's a cute little baby, and he or she is so sweet. And then of course there's always the father somewhere in a corner looking at the whole baby shower thing, and people that bring a present or something will look at the dad and get him involved, especially with comments like, she looks like just like you, she looks exactly like you. And then of course the mom over there is like, but I thought she was I thought she looked like me. And then you will sort of go through the conversation saying, well, he or she has a little bit of both of you, and but at least the father will look at his child and find things that are his. So that's smell and appearance, and especially look like the dad. Then there is a fourth thing, which is very interesting. We all know, I think most of us know, that the first smile is an exciting moment. Like, it's an exciting moment for everybody. It's a reflex. If you do a little bit of this or do a little bit of that, or you are just fooling around with a little chin, then there is a smile. So it's a reflex, but it's also, again, a survival thing for the baby. The baby has to have enough survival skills and intelligence to know that when it smiles, especially smiles when the dad is involved, holding it or giving it a diaper, new diaper, or giving it a bath, or in the bucket, or in a bath, or it's supposed to smile. Because it's not because the baby lost the mom or lost the dad. It's because it doesn't want to get killed. And as soon as it has a big head and big eyes and tiny nose and little mouth and it smiles, you know, then even a father, a man, will look at this child and think, it's giving me this little smile, and then it all, you know, it's settled, it's done, it's safe. And the more the child smiles, especially to the dad, the bigger the chances are that it won't be killed and will survive and will be accepted in the family. And so that's four things that are interesting about babies and are often misinterpreted. Fifth thing, I have to say this. When a baby is born, it also is born with a reflex that as soon as you hold it like this and support a little head with your thumbs, or and you hold it underneath your armpits, then as soon as the feet touch the ground, there is a walking reflex. It has nothing to do with power or whatever, it's just a reflex. And a lot of nurses know that when a mom is a little bit insecure, or a father is like, what am I supposed to do with this helpless little thing, when they show them that the baby has movement in the legs, the mom and the dad will interpret this as the child is healthy and is acting like it's supposed to. And nurses and doctors will say that it's a strong baby and it's confident and he is ready to take over the world and to conquer the world, and everything's going to be fine and this kid is ready to go. So that's about babies. Now, when a baby is, I talked about this in a reading a couple of days ago, smell is very important, because when a baby doesn't smell like the mom, not just the mom, but the father will have doubts about what's wrong with his child. When a child, baby or child or whatever, gets sick or is sick or there's something wrong with the nose or the lungs or something else, and it starts to be a little bit damp and feverish and coughing, and it smells like there's an infection or something. Their whole behavior changed, but also the smell changed. So when a mom or dad smell that the smell of the baby is changing, then they know there's something that needs attention, like a diet or a diaper or a fever or some kind of illness, or there's something going on in the child that needs attention. And so that's what we know. So babies being accepted and being able to present themselves as, I'm yours, I am a product of your intercourse or love or what have you, will help. And if you are trained in using smell, you will pick up on these signals a little bit quicker. But now witches will, for when witches become mom, they will not eat their own children nor kill them because of these reasons, and they won't kill or eat somebody else's babies. Now what I wanted to say is that maybe this stereotype image of a witch with a big nose and a wart or something, or some kind of weird wrath on it, shows that a witch has a nose and is using his or her nose. Now, a witch will always accept something healthy or happy or something like that as it's okay. But when something smells weird or something's off, he or she will pick up on these signs. Now, there is no pause button on this thing, which is such, this is, I don't know, I hate it. But then, I'm not one of those witch doctors in Africa that use aborted children and dry them and grind them up and put them in potions or something. Or and about Lilith, this the first wife of Adam, is Lilith, Lamia, and all kinds of other names. She is known to be a baby eating demon monster, and I do think that Lilith was vampiric in nature. And also, babies that are healthy and pure and good looking, they have a strong life force. You can't just kill a baby because their life force and the power to regenerate and renew and refresh is so strong that you might be able to use it as a battery to charge you when you are a little bit tired or something, or maybe you need energy to do a healing and you steal a little bit of that. But my belief about Lilith is that Lilith and Eve were at least sisters, if not the same woman, female being. Lilith was Adam's equal, and then she took off because she didn't want to be Adam's little helper or his servant or slave or something like that. But Eve was also not obedient, so I don't know. At some point Lilith left, and there were angels that were sent her way by God, and he was, I think, fair by saying if she wants to come back, she can come back. If she refuses, then just leave her there in the desert. These angels took it a little bit further, and they were the ones that said, Lilith, if you don't come back, we will take at least 100 of your demon children every day, every week, every month, ongoing, forever. What I think, believe, is that Lilith used the children of Eve as containers or batteries to recharge the life force in her own demonic children. That's what I believe. I don't have any research or verifications or proof or whatever. That's just me being connected with Lilith and to get a feel for what's going on. So that's another thing. I don't think that Lilith was, I think, more connected to Samael than she was connected to Asmodee. And there is a strong connection between Eve and Lilith. And I think that Eve might go more towards Asmodee's, having a relation with Asmodee. And that Lilith had more has a relation with Samael. And Adam, I don't know. I don't know what he is. I don't know who he is. I have no idea about the man, but I think he is sort of a whining little bastard or something. Little bit of a bitch. Always nagging and yapping and making drama and being depressed and I don't know. Weird guy. But that's about Lilith and Eve. And I don't think that... it feels to me that Eve was like... this punishment for my sister or equal Lilith is a little bit too rough and too cruel. You can indeed have a little bit of life force from my children and infuse your dead, killed, demonic children with the life force and bring them back to life. Now, vampiric witches are able to extract a little bit of life force from a baby and it won't hurt them. It will not hurt them or kill them or whatever. Just 3%, 5%, 10% and to expand their lifespan a little bit. And I think Lilith was able, thanks to Eve giving permission to take a little bit of her babies and bring her demonic children back to life. I hope this makes sense. So, do witches eat babies? I don't think so. I have no idea about witch doctors in Africa, nor have I any idea about reptilian Satanists that use human sacrifice and prefer offering babies to or eat them or whatever. I don't know. I have nothing to do with satanic reptilians nor African witch doctors, so I have no idea. But what I do know is that babies are very strong and very connected for a long time with the divine energy source. The divine source that is infinite and ongoing and forever and... it's still not clear to me why we lose this connection at some point, but I will get to that in another video. So, babies and witches and moms. So, if you are a mom, I would not freak your children out with Lamia or Lil or Lilith or the Night Owl or the old hag that extract life force out of them or punish them or will kill them or if they don't behave. That's cruel, by the way. That's a cruel thing. So, and witches. I don't know. I think this is it. There was something else on my mind about how we deal with babies and how babies are able to make us love them and how we become all caring and things like that, but I forgot. We meet next time. See you next time. Bye.